So Cheryl.
Yes.
Okay. What should someone do the night before the exam? Should they be like cramming? Like what do you think?
Absolutely not. And I'll just preface this by talking about the marathon. I love the discussion about the marathon. My only son was a college football player for the University of Florida Gators. So I've spent a lot of time around athletes. And what you've said is so key. It's the preparation. It's the work that goes into the preparation before, in those weeks before, which build your proficiency, which build your confidence, and which build your ability to go into that exam with the confidence that you've done your part and you will be successful. Dennis talked about the mindset. That is so important. So here we are, we've done those things. We're at the night before the big event, the big game. What do you do? Well, the first thing you want to do is get organized for the next day. You want to check the weather, see what the weather is going to be like. Lay out your clothes. Prepare your breakfast, perhaps, in advance. Make sure there's gas in the car. And check the drive time to the test center. You know, those little things can, at the last minute, become hiccups for you that cause a lot of stress. So preparation, even in those things, is helpful. Of course, you probably may have a few last minute things you want to review as preparation for the exam, but for the most part, you should be focused on eating a good meal, you know, and minimizing like caffeine, for example, because sleep is so important the night before the exam. So if you're drinking a lot of colas or soda, or even some herbal teas containing a lot of caffeine, that may help disturb your sleep. Right. So on top of your natural anxiety, now you're putting caffeine in your system and it really could negatively affect your ability to get a good night's sleep. So perhaps you want to do some things to relax and help relieve any stress that you have. Maybe a little light exercise, a little walk, perhaps some stretching. If you're into yoga, do a little bit of that, perhaps. But mostly you want to practice breathing, and above all, just visualize the positive outcome. See yourself. The power of the mind is really just now really beginning to be tapped into. And you can visualize yourself in the test center. You can visualize yourself successfully answering those questions. And last tip I will say before I'll transfer it back to you is please remember to set your alarm clock so that you don't oversleep.
It's so true. It's so true.
It's the little thing to get you.
It is. It's so true. I mean, I could share some stories. I know we're almost out of time, unfortunately. And I could definitely share some stories. So check the weather. Definitely. That's a thing, especially if you're in the north. Yes. Gas in the car. Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Cheryl.